Hello everyone, this is Kalyan from Blackbox Tech. In today's episode, I will show you how to add a voice search in your website within just few minutes. So without further ado, let's get started. To add a voice search in our application, I will first go to our app component HTML. I will add a form tag. And in action, I will add Google search URL. Next, I will add an ID. And for method, I will add get. To access it from our class, I will add a reference to it. Inside this form, I will add another div as a wrapper. Now I will add a hidden input which will hold the return data from search. I'll also add a reference to access this element as well. I will add a name attribute Q. So during form submit, it will add with search URL including search phrase. I will add another div which will hold the mic icon. Now I will add a click event and bind with a function called voice search. Now let's run ng-serve to check the UI. For this icon, I have borrowed the CSS from CodePen. You can get this code from the URL added in the video description. Now let's add the interaction by going into our app component TS. I will add the page title first as it is coming blank. So these two elements reference can be accessed through a ViewChild decorator in the class. Let's add that decorator with two different reference.
Now I will add the function which will trigger on click of mic icon, and I'm giving a name to voice search. I have created a snippet which will auto-generate the function. If you want to know how to do it, please watch my video about VS Code snippet. We need to declare a var for the WebKit speech recognition here, and in TypeScript it will not complain again. Now let's go through the function. In the first line, I am checking if WebKit speech recognition is available in the browser. If not, it will throw an error. Now I will create an instance and store in the constant. I am making this continuous property to false, so it will wait for the whole sentence to be complete before return the result. And also interim to false, so it will not alter text before returning a result. And I am setting US English as language, but you can create a select box which will hold all the available language and pass whatever is selected from it. Now I am triggering the start. I am adding the two DOM element reference inside this constant. In the success callback, I am storing the resulted string in the hidden input value. Then I am stopping the voice recognition and submitting the form with the value. If there is an error, I am just log the error and stop the execution. And I am also logging if the browser do not support this voice recognition feature. Now test this to search something in Google. Angular Universal Tutorial Videos, YouTube, Black Box Tech.
And that's it for today. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share, like and subscribe. And also don't forget to ring the bell so you will get notified about my next video. Thanks.